Now let's head to Cambridge for a beautiful story of teenage compassion and understanding.
It centres around a student named Tommy who's staring down a few challenges, but knowing he has a whole school behind him. Here's Michael Holland. Let's go!
It's humbling and really just insane.
Check, one, two.
An incredible bunch of people.
Sounds like they care for you, Tommy.
Yeah, I've been overwhelmed at the amount of care and support that people have shown towards me.
We've seen them many times before, the big-hearted sacrificing their sense of self for all the right reasons.
Have a little rub of your head.
But for mine, the warm vibe here at Cambridge High School and their love for head boy Tommy O'Brien is genuinely top of the class.
Because if we're being blunt, testicular cancer is not the easiest thing to talk about.
No, it is a private thing. It can be bigger
than this. Private and now oh so public at the age of 18.
I never would have expected for my final year at high school that I'd be the guy with testicular cancer, but that is what it is, and I think it's getting people talking.
Honestly, he's powering through it and I'm proud of him.
Who he is has a huge impact on the school.
And he's an absolute trooper. He just has such a positive attitude even though he's going through the worst part of his life.
What do you take away from that group hug?
Just a feeling of warmth and encouragement. It makes it slightly easier on the tough days and gives me hope, and I think that's really special.
They want to be part of your journey.
Yeah, and it means a lot to me.
Tommy receiving his diagnosis just weeks after returning from a school exchange to Switzerland, then undergoing surgery to remove a tumour just as COVID descended upon us, and now follow-up sessions of chemotherapy.
Do you fall into dark places or are you optimistic all the time?
I'd say most of the time, yes. But there have been certain days where there's nothing you can do except really think. And you can kind of spiral down into a place where you don't really know what's happening anymore. And being with people is the best way of dealing with something that's tough on you mentally.
And make no mistake, these are Tommy's people, shaving for a cure.
We'll open up your mind and see like me.
Racing stripes. It's a big question, Mr. Dread. Are you dreading it?
Oh, I'm kind of looking forward to it.
Useless hair. Oh, that looks so nice. We'll open up
your mind. Very, very, very brave. But you've always been brave. So. I'll look into your heart and you will find
that the sky is yours. You have raised more than $16,000 for Shape for a Cure. It's quite remarkable.
If my journey, I suppose, can help anyone, I'd be really proud of that.
Because you might be head boy, but really, you're just plain old Tommy.
Exactly, and I think that's the most important thing to remember is you're just who you are. You've got to be happy with yourself and take life as it is. Just live.
Well, let me tell you, ordinary Tommy, I think you're also very courageous. Well done.
Thank you. Thank you, Michael.
You know, we met some pretty inspirational people here at Seven Sharp, but Tommy, boy oh boy.
Oh, Tommy O'Brien, for the entire school to get behind you like they have, you must be a very special individual, and I think it says a lot about the school that you were at as well, those scenes. So well done to all of you.
Good on you.